were almost completely flooded again a few weeks ago. Here, Kath is musing on what's in the countryside, that's whizzing past her as she goes. She's travelling to Hebden Bridge from London. She does a regular commute to be with her girlfriend.
In case anybody doesn't know, Hebden Bridge has a large lesbian population, and in the north, a phrase if somebody's become a lesbian, it's she's taking the train to Hebden Bridge.
Oh, she's taking the train.
Yeah, she's taking the train to Hebden Bridge, but she's literally taking the train to Hebden Bridge.
And she's just been to a talk on, would you believe, soil health. And she's reflecting upon what is in the landscape. Mm. In this story, I'm trying to get across some things which perhaps aren't that necessarily exciting or fascinating at first glance, but I hope that I've managed to make them interesting. Because actually soil health is crucial to our life on Earth, our continuance as a species, ultimately. And she's just been to this soil science talk, and she's reflecting upon what's in there. As it says at the top, there are as many life forms in a handful of soil as there are people on the planet, if not more. So I thought I'd get Bryan to draw them on.
They've drawn quite soon as well.
But I think this is a double spread as well. You know, and again, that really punctuates beautifully the storytelling, kind of brings us back to focus on this kind of the subliminal messages.
Good. I wasn't sure what the reception would be to lots of wiggly things.
Mary's actually been a member of the Soil Research Association for about 2 decades.
Ever since I got a decent sized garden that I could get my hands into, I've been fascinated by understanding how things work in it. So we start with single-celled organisms and get larger.
Not very clear, this slide.
No,
it's not clear in the book.
There's a huge centipede. And larger and larger until she's jolted out of her reverie. Okay. The story is about contestation and struggle, I suppose. It's about finding out about issues and trying to decide what to do about them, trying to decide how to do a fight back against them. And that involves all kinds of things, including, of course, demonstrations. Also, sabotage, for some.
We show a couple of different action groups. This lot called Gay's Children, and there's another lot for slightly heavier bunch called Ecotage.
As far as I know, I made up the term Ecotage, but it sounded so plausible.